imagine if Brian Cowan explained his policies through the medium of folk song, or if Enda Kenny challenged one of his front benchers to a sword fighting match every morning. If our politicians were more like Bob Roberts, I think more people would be arsed getting up and voting for them. Bob Roberts is actually the brainchild of Tim Robbins, who wrote, directed, created the music, did everything for this film. He's got a great singing voice, you should check it out. It's about the fictional senatorial race between himself, the charismatic Republican folk singer, and his crusty old rival, the Democratic Gore Vidal. Gore Vidal's brilliant in this film. He never rehearsed any of his lines. It was all ad-libbed and improvised from the start. Really is an excellent performance. There's me giving stick to the Irish system when the US system's just as bad. You have to choose between the Democrats who cannot govern and the Republicans who are just plain evil. There's loads of cameos in this film, including James Spader, John Cusack, Helen Hunt, Susan Sarandon. Jack Black even makes his feature film debut, I believe, in this film. And would you believe it? He plays a guitar in a rock band. Speaking of typecasting, actually, do you know who turns up as the possibly shady associate of Tim Robbins' character? Alan Rickman. Yes, Alan Rickman of I'll Get You, Mr. Potter, Mr. Hood, Mr. McLean. What a heck. Actually, do you know who else crops up? Saddam Hussein. And there's one stage, John Cusack's character makes a joke about weapons of mass destruction. How freaky is that? And at one stage, there's also a smoking gun in this film, but the one in the film actually turns up. 3E Movie Club gives you Bob Roberts.